So today we're going to talk on the diversity in biotic environment and species relationship. This is the first part of the lecture. Now, conservation of species depends on their sustenance in their habitats. And if you understand the patterns of the species interrelationship, it helps, and also the principles of animal ecology, it helps to rationalize our conservation efforts. So in this lecture, you will see different types of relationship that exist. So to begin with, very basic, you know, the principles of animal ecology, what you know as biotic environment, and that means the living components of a species, that is plants, animals, fungi, microbes, and interactions of organisms with the members of own species and with other species. Now, a quick recap of some of the fundamental definitions of animal ecology is what we mean by a species, a group of organisms that can interbreed and produce fertile, viable offspring. And when you talk about population, a group of organisms of the same species, that is very, very important. The individuals should belong to the same species that live together in the same area at the same time. And when you say community, a group of populations, now they will belong to different species. So many populations of belonging to many species, when they live and interact with each other in an ecosystem, that makes a community. Now it's very, very important to understand the underlying principles of the community relationship, the interspecific relationship, when we study the biodiversity of area or make policy decision about the conservations. Now, quickly look at the levels of organizations and individuals. The non-living components are the living components, which I've just mentioned that they're the biotic components. So you look at the bottom, the way the all living components, they are made up of cells, then makes the tissue, tissue makes the organ system, that makes the organisms, and we have defined how we define population, eco, community, and so on. So our lecture will be based on these levels, and so that's a part of the animal ecology. And this is a schematic which tells you that the individual, the population, the community, the ecosystem, biome, and biosphere. So we'll be dealing with the population and the species. The relationship can be of two types, intraspecific, that the between organisms of the same species, or interspecific, between two different species. Now, it's a just, you know, a pictorial contrast between the population and the community. As I told you, the population means the members of the same species, and the community, you know, it's a multiple species. Now, the two lectures, the part one and part two, is focused on the relationship within or amongst the organism individuals belonging to same species. Now, individuals of a community, they are related to one another either through their cooperative or disoperative coactions. Now, there exists a delicate balance between them, and this relationship can be beneficial or it can be harmful. Now, it may affect the single individual, it may affect the group of animals, or it may affect the whole community. And the factors that influence intraspecific relationship are as follows, like reproduction, competition, social and communal, assistance, parental care. Now, let's first start off with the main factor, reproduction, that influences the intraspecific relationship. Now, all organisms possess an inherent characteristic to reproduce and to exist. But this rate of reproduction and the ability to survive depends on biotic potential. It's a very important terminology in animal ecology. The biotic potential of a species can be defined as the maximum number of individuals a species can produce. Now, it differs. Now, this graph, adjoining graph, you can see that that is a, you know, the limit that's called the carrying capacity. And carrying capacity varies from, you know, the one group of species to the another, you know, these species. And that is the beyond the scope of today's lecture. You can find out, you know, the many resources like, you know, the books or wherever you can find out the factors which can affect the carrying capacity. But mainly the environmental resistance, and this environmental resistance can be intrinsic or it can be extrinsic. Now, this biotic potential, if you see, so there is an exponential growth, and this, you know, the slope depends on the species to species. Some species has a very high biotic potential, and you can see a population, you know, the size increases. There is an within a very short time. Now, the reproduction, as I've just mentioned, if the biotic potential is high, where will it lead to? It will lead to overproduction, which will lead to, again, competition. So remember, these are interrelated. I just repeat, if the biotic potential is high, it will lead to overproduction. Overproduction will lead to competition. But the competition can be for food, for space, or for mate. And when you talk about, you know, the competition within the members of the same species, you know, this basically mate is reproductive, like for purpose, mate is an important, you know, the parameter. But when it's interspecific relationship, that is members of two different species, the third factor, parameter, which I have just mentioned for mate, that doesn't exist. Okay, now let's just start one by one. For food, stronger get more food, weaker deprive the diet. For food, if this food scarcity increases, there can be wide-scale migration to new territory, because, you know, they will search for the new place where there will be enough nutritional resources. So migration is one of the fallout of competition. Now, in the beginning, you have seen reproduction, then overproduction. Overproduction leads to competition, and then, you know, the competition for food leads to migration. Now, this is a very enigmatic feature in evolution, that many times you would see that the food scarcity increases, there can be incidences of cannibalism. What do you mean by that? That animals eat members of their own species. There are many things are not known because there are cases of cannibalism where the food is not a factor. So there are sometimes, you know, the reasons cannot be understood yet, but this is one of the subject, you know, that is quite, you know, the keeping us busy, many of the ecologists and evolutionary biologists. Now, cannibalism is widespread in many, many vertebrates and even in invertebrates. Okay, and for space, let's move on. The shelter, lower animals can still live without showing any interaction, like, let's say, leaf-eating insects. Okay. So you do not find, you know, there much competition, but the higher animals show hostility, and competitions for space can lead to extreme territorial behavior. It can lead to a behavior which can lead to physical aggressions, or even, you know, the can lead to death. You can just see that the territorial behavior can lead to lots of, you know, the physical aggressions. It can lead to injury to members, and then it ultimately death can also occur. And you can see many times they mark the territory with urinations, or so this volatile, you know, the hydrocarbons, you know, they help them to understand. They get the olfactory signal, the limit of the territory, and if this territory is violated, then they become alert, and then severe aggression starts. And you can see this is quite, you know, the common in many of the animals where, you know, the urine, you know, that they mark their territory. Territorial behavior is quite common in the birds also. You can see interspecific competition for mate. Now mate, you know, the competition depends on many times the gender ratio. Male female ratio is one of the factors. And it can also lead to aggressions and large scale, you know, the violent behavior. Now, these are very rare, you know, the examples, like female antelopes fighting for mates. Okay, generally you find that the males, you know, they fight for a female mate. So many males are competing, you know, to mate a female. So there can be a competition, but female also, they end up in the fighting for mates. There's a very interesting case. You can see a male bird, like a tern, you know, they chasing other males and waiting for courting the female with gifts in their mouth. So you can see the front of slide, the second one is holding something and a tiny piece of food. And the mate will come, the female will come, and whoever is having an attractive, gift, they will choose that mate. So there are diversity of different types of mating behavior and competitions underlying that. So from here we lead to now the third factor called parental care. It's very, very important, because the sustenance of a species depends on the type of parental care that they show to their offspring. And the survivability offspring is very, very important for the perpetuation and the sustenance of species population. Now, interspecific, the interaction for parental care, you will find all animals like vertebrates and invertebrates, they show different types of the parental care, and parental care ensures the survival of the offsprings to their adulthood, and that's how the populations can sustain and perpetuate. Okay, and so different animals have different types and diversity of parental care can be seen. Even you can see this invertebrate, this is a Bellostoma, okay, a giant water bug. So they take care of the eggs. So basically you can see that the female glues the fertilized eggs on the back of the male, and the males of the most insect species provide no parental care for the offspring, but the male giant water bug carries for the, so mostly you find the females do parental care. There are many, many exceptions where the males also, do take part in parental care. You can see the male marmoset showing parental care. This is a very nice picture, and a baby hippo. Okay, now in the parental care, what are the evolutionary implications? I leave these questions to the participants. Or the audience, to think about it and they can give their feedback. Interspecific interaction, social life, and a communal relationship. When you discuss about this, you can see there are different type of the communal behavior. Okay, here the communal behavior comes from the ecological sense, from the community, and it's not should not be misunderstood with other type of dictionary meaning which we have, like a communal word is there. So this is basically ecological term. And so some animals are solitary, some are gregarious. That means they show togetherness for their own survival. Okay, so we'll lead to the next part. Thank you very much.